Shortcuts let you automate the things you do on your phone every day. In the Shortcuts app, you can visually string together actions offered by the apps you have installed. You can run a shortcut just by asking Siri or by putting a widget on your home screen. Not a lot of people know this powerful feature exists, so as an introduction, I'm going to show you the 8 best shortcuts to show you what's possible. Let's start with one of the more basic shortcuts that you can set up yourself. If you regularly go into the Settings app to change the same few things over and over again, you might be able to automate it with a shortcut. For example, the Settings app offers a bunch of accessibility toggles for all of those features that you can add to your shortcut. And under the Scripting category, in the Device section, you can set things like the orientation lock, the screen brightness, the volume, even locking or powering off the device. Using the Get Focus action, you can even have these settings be context aware, whether you're at work or at home, if you have focus modes set up. For example, I have 2 shortcuts that I can access from my lock screen. One turns on light mode and changes the text size to its default setting. Another one switches to dark mode and lowers the text size to where I like to keep it personally. I use these for taking screenshots and making screen recordings for my videos, but anybody could use these if you want to make your phone more legible on a bright sunny day outside. Next up, you can use shortcuts to turbocharge your iPhone's action button. If your iPhone has an action button, you probably set it up when you first got it, maybe used it once or twice within the first week, and promptly forgot about it ever since. But you can get more out of it because you can assign the action button to a shortcut that can do anything. For example, if you use ChatGPT or other voice assistants like Google Assistant or Amazon Alexa, you can assign them to the action button. Create a new shortcut using the Ask Google action or the Open App action and set it to whatever app you want. Then assign that shortcut to the action button and you can just click it to open your favorite chatbot. If you often say to yourself, "Ooh, I should add that to my grocery list," and you literally never do, you can solve that problem with the action button. Create a new shortcut using the Add New Reminder action. Tell it to ask for input and assign it to your shopping list, and then assign that shortcut to the action button. With one click, you can instantly add items to your shopping list. Can't decide on just one thing? Well, who said you can only pick one? Make a shortcut with the Choose From Menu action to make the action button bring up a quick menu of settings. I made a whole video on more things the action button can do in this video here. Next up, let's talk about images. The iPhone tries to make you not think about image file formats, but they're still important. Pictures are taken in either HEIC or JPEG formats, or as Apple describes them, more efficient and more compatible. The Photos app supports animated GIFs, but it also supports similar looking live photos that can be turned into looping animations that are actually completely different behind the scenes. And sometimes the difference matters. With just one shortcut that you can download by tapping here, you can regain control of your photo formats. After you've downloaded the shortcut, tap the 3 dots button on the upper right, and then tap the I, and make sure Show in Share Sheet is checked. Now, when you go back to your photos, you can tap the share sheet on any one, tap convert image, and set it to whatever format you want. Animated GIF, which only works on live photos or videos, JPEG, or PNG. These will come in handy if you're trying to upload an image to the web that only accepts JPEG but not HEIC, if you're trying to share a GIF in a third-party app that doesn't support live photos, or if you're trying to download an image from the web that only serves in that irritating WebP format. Next up, the Apple Frames shortcut by Mac Stories is an absolute masterpiece. It takes an ordinary screenshot in your photo library and adds your phone on top of it for a much more professional looking image. It works in both portrait and landscape orientations and on Apple Watch, iPad, and certain models of Mac. It's not just for tech bloggers like me. If you ever want to put a screenshot on social media, in a presentation, in a document, on a flyer, the Apple Frames shortcut adds one quick step with much more professional looking cleaner results. You can copy the image to your clipboard to paste on a different device, add it to your photo library, save it to files, or bring up the share sheet to airdrop it or send it over messages. It even has settings where you can customize it to your liking. You can choose whether an input of multiple images will piece them all together in one, or save them as multiple separate images. You can even make a different shortcut that controls the Apple Frames shortcut for making custom actions without picking apart the immensely complicated Apple Frames shortcut itself. Next up is a shortcut that adds a missing feature to Apple Music. You see, on the Mac app, you can bring up the Up Next queue, and with one button you can clear the entire contents. On the iPhone, you can bring up this list by tapping this button in the bottom right of the Now Playing screen, and you can swipe left on an item to delete it one by one, but there's not a single button where you can clear the entire list at once. However, if you download the Clear Apple Music Queue shortcut, there's an easy way to do it. Anywhere you see this three dots button, tap on that, tap Share, and then scroll down, and in the share sheet you'll see Clear Apple Music Queue. Just tap that, and instantly, your queue is empty. For easier access, you can also add this shortcut to your home screen. One of the more fun features of the iPhone is the ability to copy things out of photos as stickers that you can drop in an iMessage chat or a Snapchat. But it's not easy adding a sticker on top of another photo without using a third-party app like Pixelmator. This Overlay Images shortcut makes it incredibly easy. You pick your starting photo, then you pick the photo you'd like to add on top of it, and you can choose whether to cut out the background or not. Then you can move it around and resize it on top, and just tap Done to save it to your photo library. And just like that, you've combined two photos. This next shortcut is incredibly simple, but it's honestly a lifesaver: open in Safari. If you're ever inside an app and you want to open what you're looking at in the web browser, but you can't figure out how, well, if you can find the share sheet, then you can tap Open in Safari to open it in Safari. It's honestly a lifesaver. Last but not least, one of the superpowers of the iPhone is that it can act as a remote for the Apple TV. And it's super convenient. You can just bring up Control Center, tap the remote button, and there it is. You don't have to download an app, you don't have to sign into anything. It's built into every iPhone. But sometimes having an app icon on your home screen would be really convenient, especially if you're an Apple TV power user. Well, you can add one by making a Siri shortcut. Get started by downloading the remote shortcut here. Then in the Shortcuts app, tap the three dots button to edit it. Then you're going to tap Apple TV and specify which Apple TV you want to control. If you have multiple Apple TVs in your life, then you can tap Ask Each Time. Then add it to your home screen by tapping the share button and tap Add to Home Screen. You can put the icon wherever you want, and now you have a faster way to access the remote without bringing up Control Center every time. So those are 8 examples of what you can do with shortcuts. To check out more ways you can customize your phone, click this video here. Remember to like and subscribe. I'm D. Griffin Jones with Cult of Mac.